Hey guys, welcome to the 7th lecture of our tunnel project using Cebes 3D. And in this lecture we will learn how to create a railway tunnel assembly using Autodesk Sub-Assembly Composer and how to import this assembly to Cebes 3D. So in this lecture our objective is to create a double railway tunnel assembly for Cebes 3D using Autodesk Sub-Assembly Composer. And the important thing in this lecture is to apply Kant at both tracks. That is the output section that we wanna make at end of this lecture. And its component are circular tunnel, double track railway, each track at each site, and that filling concrete at bottom of track. So at end of this lecture we wanna get this section tunnel with two railway tracks. And before you see this lecture, I recommend you to watch these two lectures, because these two lectures are important before following this video. The first lecture to follow is how to create circular tunnel assembly with variable dimension using Autodesk Sub Assembly Composer. And you can see this lecture in my channel. That is my channel. Go to playlist, tunnel project Cebes 3D, and this lecture 4. That is the first lecture that you should follow, because it's very important in our lecture. And another one is go to videos. And you will see this video, important skill, how to learn how to create sub-assembly using sub-assembly composer. In this video you will learn some skills in sub-assembly composer to create sub-assembly. And in this lecture you will learn the basic of Autodesk sub-assembly composer. So you should follow these two lectures before start to create railway tunnel assembly. That is first lecture, and the second lecture, and I attach the link in video description. Let's begin the steps that we will follow in our lecture. To make railway tunnel assembly, we will depend on two samples. Assembly, one from Autodesk samples and one from assembly that we have created in lecture 4. In lecture 4 we have learned how to create circular tunnel assembly but with variable dimension. So the assembly created from this lecture, we will input this assembly as a base for our lecture. And that is example. This assembly will depend also in our lecture. So the first assembly will input it by download sample PK team file. We'll download this sample and we'll open this file because it will be important in our lecture and it will be the base for our lecture. So the first step is to download samples for Autodesk SubAssembly Composer from Autodesk. Now I will learn you how to find these samples. Google will type SubAssembly Composer sample BKT file. We'll go to this link. And download this package, and in this package you will get some samples from Autodesk SubAssembly Composer, and in this package we will get our wanted assembly real-time example.pkt for Autodesk SubAssembly Composer. And from this we can open a real-time example, and from this assembly we can start our lecture. So we'll open this file using Autodesk SubAssembly Composer. Let's start with Autodesk SubAssembly Composer and open this file. We'll get to file, open, and we'll get its location. And we'll search for this. As you see, here can't example. That is the first assembly that we will input to our section, and we'll modify this assembly for our lecture. That is the second step. The third step is to omit unwanted section, as we see above. We need in rail cant assembly we need only rails and sleepers. We don't want ballast or subballast. We need only rails and sleeper. So we will delete ballast and subballast. So in this step we'll omit sub flow chart for ballast and sub ballast, because we'll select ballast and sub ballast and click delete. So our assembly for rail is ready for our output assembly. So we have ended from third step. The fourth step is important, and to input parameter distance between two rails, two tracks. At start of this lecture, we have mentioned that we wanna create double track assembly. Double track assembly that we need track in each side. So we need to input a parameter that describe distance between two tracks. So we'll input this parameter. To input this parameter, جيت تو انبوت اوت بوت كريت بارامتر distance between two tracks. And we'll name it as this parameter as DT track. And we'll input default value for this distance between two track as for example 4 meter. So we have ended from first step distance between two tracks because we'll input double railway in this tunnel section. Based on this parameter, the step is to shift sub-assembly from center by this parameter. This assembly will shift it to the right or to left by the half of distance between two tracks. This assembly is at center of assembly because the default is single track, but we need double track, so we will shift this assembly to right by half of distance between two tracks. So we will shift this assembly by moving this point P1 and P2. So we will shift this point to the right, and based on that the whole section will move to the right. So we'll start with P1 and we can make this shift by get to delta x, and we'll add the distance of between two tracks. We'll copy this parameter and we'll add it in delta x. To remember, we should save this file or this project file save as. So on delta x we'll add a distance track by half. So as you see P1 or another mean the right rail is shifted to the right by this distance, and we will make the same for P2. Delta x will add distance between two tracks, distance track by half. So we have shifted the track assembly to the right, and we have make changes for first assembly. This assembly is a rear track, and let's start with second assembly and the second assembly that we have created from lecture 4. So you should watch lecture 4, and you should learn how to create some circular tunnel assembly from this lecture, and the output assembly will be used in this lecture. So the created assembly from lecture 4, we will copy this this assembly into our project. So we'll open the created assembly from lecture 4, and I will remember you lecture 4 is this lecture 4. At the end of this lecture you will get this section, and the section will be used in our lecture. I will attach this video link in my video description. So we'll open the second assembly. That is the resulted assembly from lecture 4 that you should follow. In this assembly we will copy two things. We'll copy this point, and we will copy this 3 parameter radius that represent radius of circular tunnel, and the thickness that represent tunnel thickness, and we'll copy filling concrete thickness. That's so we'll copy the point and link in this section, and we'll copy or input these 3 parameters because they are very important in our lecture assembly. Copy this section and paste it to our project. We should make a screen shot for this assembly and for flow chart, because when we'll copy this assembly and transfer it to our project, the point and links will be renumbered. So we will modify the pasted assembly based on this flowchart and this section. So we'll make a screenshot we'll make screenshot sniping tool screenshot for this section. Save. And we'll make screenshot. For flowchart in two parts, because flowchart is too long. Flowchart 1. and that's part 2. So in this step, we will copy the parameter of tunnel section and paste it to our project. So we'll paste point and the length, all this. And we'll paste it to our project. Another project that we have created. Paste by control V or by right click and paste. As you see, as a point are renumbered, this point are renumbered because this assembly are pasted after rail assembly. The rail assembly is the first, and the tunnel assembly that we have copied is the second one. So the point renumbered after the number of rail tunnel, rail assembly. Will input the parameter of tunnel. We will input this three parameters: radius, tunnel thickness, filling thickness. The next step is to link between two assemblies, rail and circular tunnel assembly. And the zero level will be the top of rail. And the distance between the top of rail and the middle of the lever is 0.272. And this distance is very important. This distance is between the top of rail and this point. So it will be about this value, but it approximately is the sum of 0.172, and this distance as the output distance is about 0.272. So we'll link between the two assembly, and we'll modify the tunnel assembly based on top of rail. Mi-35 SP1. Mi-35 SP1 in tunnel section. As we have mentioned before, the points are renumbered. So the first point in tunnel assembly will be B35. Uh, to link between this point and the tunnel assembly as we see. This point based on top of rail and filling sectors. So delta y will be 2 of radius minus filling thickness minus so we have modified the first point on our entire assembly and we'll modify the other point based on this point B36 is second point. P2 and B2 the relation between this point and the first point that is in delta x it will be radius and delta y it will be radius in both delta x and delta y. But it we should it should based from from point the first point or point 35 about delta x it will be positive and delta y it will be negative. So that is for second point, point 36.
The next point is point 37, and that is the first point B3. It will be based on P2 or B1 from B1, if it's based on from B1 or point 35 in our assembly, delta x will be 0 and delta y will be negative diameter or double radius. So point 37 will be based on point 35 delta y it will be a minus double radius point 38 is a force point. Force point represent the outer perimeter of tunnel. And it will be shift from B1 by tunnel thickness. So it will be to from B35 and the link is shifted automatically B39 or 0.5 P5 is P38. Will be P39 will be based from P37 P40 that is the success point P6 and it's based on B3 by tunnel thickness in delta x. B3 in this section is B36. And we'll modify the point and the linkage based on area. We'll make an arc for inner site. This arc will link between B35, B36, and B37. And the other arc will link between the next point B38, B40, and B39. The start point is B38 and arc point is B40 and end point is point 39. And we'll create a shape for a tunnel. We'll click select shape. And we'll click on inner, inner shape. Point 41 is based on B3 is B37 this assembly. So in this example, we should see the tunnel section to modify this section based on a new number. So it will be based on B37. The arbitrary point will be based on B7. B7 in this assembly is point 41. We make this step to create a point for to create top of filling concrete. The intersection point is between between auxiliary link L2 and the arc link. Arc link is this, and that is auxiliary link. The intersection of this two link will create the point that we need. The link 45 will link between P7 and B8. P7 and B8 is link is the top of filling concrete, but we don't need this link, so we'll omit it. We'll delete it and we'll link again. The auxiliary point is based on B3. B3, this point is B37. And the arbitrary point is there. And the intersection point is created to present the arc of filling concrete thickness. And this intersection point is between auxiliary link 3 and the arc. The intersection is the intersection of L42 and auxiliary link A3. And we'll make an arc between this 3 point, B42, B43 and B37. This 2 point will link between this 3 point.
And we'll delete shape we need for it. And to finish our section, we will link between between the end arc point, between these two point. We will link between the this point to close filling concrete section. And you see here that the cant is applied, and that is the important thing in our section. We will link between between this point to close our section. So we'll make a link between point 31 and point 41. And another link. تورنت بتوين بوينت 32 اند بوينت 42. So we have ended from right side of our rail way tunnel assembly. That is steps of right side of assembly, and to create the left side, we'll make we'll copy our created section and paste it to another project.